Hey everybody, it's Linda with Stamping School. This week I'm going to use the Sparkle of the Season bundle from the Stampin' Up. I call it the holiday catalog, but it's the mini catalog from August to December 2021. So this I actually ordered by accident. That bundle number is very close to a ribbon. And I actually got this by accident, but I really like it. So it ended up being a good thing. So it kind of reminds me of that all-season wreath that we had last year that retired, in that you can have Thanksgiving, Halloween, Christmas, winter, or just in general some nice wreaths. So this is quite a big set of dies. I think there's 15 of those. And this is what they kind of all look like. So you got the three different wreaths right here. You've got one with leaves, and then you've got one with stars, and this one right here with pines. So like a pine needles. This one is, I just did this in white, which is this one, and just used some of the markers on it just to see what it looked like colored. And then you've got all of these, which we'll stamp and cut with the dies, and a little pumpkin, so some leaves, and a little pine cone, and some pine needles. For Halloween, they've got a little bat. Oh, I lost my bat. Well, I don't know where he went, but it's a little bit bigger than the stamp. So there's a little stamp with a set of three there. And then the die, which is just a little bit bigger. Cute little broom. Some little extra leaves. This one can be holly. There's a die right here that has six of those that you can use for, you know, the little berries. So you could just stamp everything on here, but I really like cutting out these little wreaths. Nice little sentiments. May the sparkle of the season warm your heart and home. It's nice. So the first one I'm going to show you is Halloween, and then I'll show you Thanksgiving, and then I'll show you Christmas. And I have most of these ready to go, so I'm just going to show you a few little things that I did. This paper is that Blackberry Beauty paper. It is 12 by 12. It is gorgeous. It was out for a long time. I mean, we didn't even have it during our pre-order, but it's here, and it's really spectacular. Just all that gold, that shiny gold. So it's Razzleberry. There's the other side. And Blackberry with the gold. It's the other side. And this has two of these on there in different directions. So you can cut these off and make panels of cards. So you'll get six of those pretty panels. Isn't that pretty? So this is their take on the fall paper this year, is to do this color palette with the cinnamon cider and the blackberry. Isn't that pretty? I'll show you that on the fall one. And some pretty birds. And this one actually has owls on it. Can you see those? So that's what I did, even though it's probably more fall, their intention, but I did it for Halloween. So I cut out the leaf die with the black glitter paper that's in the holiday catalog, put it on a Razzleberry card, and this right here is this paper. But what I did is I took some Memento ink, which is not waterproof, so I just took my ink pad and went directly over that, like that. Turn it around to the other side. There you go. Grab a tissue or a paper towel so you can get your fingers all icky. Right. And then that ink is going to resist. Oops, now my finger's inky. Let me do this so I can hold on to that little end. There we go. And just wipe off all the extra. So it does a resist technique, kind of. And it won't stick to that gold. As long as your ink is not waterproof, it won't stick. So I did that once or twice just to get it almost black. And then I just added it right here. Now it probably would just, it would look fine if you left it. The Razzleberry. See, it'd probably be fine. I just really liked it being just a little bit darker and a little more mysterious looking. So the little owl there I cut out from the paper. This is just a circle punch with, I stamped the black little bats on. And then I just added some Winkostella. So I kind of shook it down and then tapped it to give them some sparkle in the background. I did a little bit of rhinestones right here and then colored them with my Blends marker. So just to make them Razzleberry color. And that's it. Oh, and that pretty black glitter ribbon. that we have that carried over. If you take your Blends marker or a Sharpie, and because this is an alcohol marker, and just kind of go over these little places that are silver, that turns that razzleberry too, which is kind of pretty. Oh, you're not gonna see it on camera, are you? But it's very pretty. All right, so that is my first one. So I had a request from Trisha to use these basic border dies. So these come by themselves in the Stampin' Up! Annual catalog. Yeah. So there's a little, there's some zigzag, and they're all stitched. And this pretty little scallop, this can be used for clouds, and this one, so you can use it for envelopes. But I ended up using it for the fall card to do this one right here. Let me see that. I'll show you how I did that. Before that, I got this cutie in the mail. This is from one of my talented team members, Debbie Heilman. She's in Florida. Look how cute that is. So she used this one right here along the edge. See the stitching? Yeah, it's cute. So she's got this one done with black and this one done with that grape color. It's really fun. A fun little Halloween card. I just love that double scallop border though. So we're gonna use this one to create this bottom. And there's a little bit of a trick for getting that little layer on there. So the first thing I did, I took that panel from that Blackberry Beauty. It's 4 by 5 1/4. And I just put this down at the bottom right here and cut that end off. And it's about 1 1/4 inches. I measured up from each side just to make sure, you know, when I eyeballed it, that it wasn't gonna be too off center. So when you run that through your machine, you know, be careful. If you've got the Big Shot, this is a little over 6. So I don't know if it'll work, but in the Stampin' Up! Machine, it has enough room to slide through because this end is just about 6 1/4 almost. So you may have to run it through sideways and not do it as a cut card. So just watch it as you're running it through. So I ran that through. I can save this piece for something. And this can go right here. And you can leave it just like that if you want to as a card. You can just glue it on there and be done. But of course, I want to do a little extra. So I tack this on the top right here on the layer, just like that. And then I ran it through again with this butted up right next to that. And I put a little piece of tape on there, just a real little piece, ran it through again. And that's how I got that little border right there, and it's stitched. It's pretty. Now, if you want to, on the inside of your card, you can actually put this piece down there, and then that just closes like that, which I like that too. Then you're not wasting that. It's really pretty. And then when they open it, you know, it looks like that. So it's up to you which way you like better. I might like it better like that, but I'm not sure. You decide. So then I just added vanilla. I cut that out with my circles. Cut a piece of vanilla out and stamped it in the razzleberry. And then I took the next size up and did another little piece of razzleberry back there and then just added this in the gold. And I ended up using the brushed metallic gold, which is really pretty. It really picks up the gold in the paper. A few little sequins, and that is done. And on the inside, I did the same thing, the same vanilla circle with razzleberry behind it and a little piece of designer paper. And I just stamped thankful for you, and I have a little place to sign. Of course, if you have to say a lot more, you can cut a piece here if you want to, but I'm just gonna sign it. And this is actually the cinnamon cider, which is interesting how it looks on the blackberry. I think it's very fall. And my friend Connie said, that paper doesn't look fall to me. And I'm like, I really think it does. I think that the cinnamon cider really pulls in those fall colors, and it works. Okay, so that's the second one. And the last one is Christmas. And this one, I really wanted to do white on white, but it ended up, I needed a little bit more color with it. So I decided to do white and gold and the real red. And I made it a 5 by 5 card, but this could easily be a regular 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So this is what I did. I took a piece of 4 1/2 inch by 4 1/2 inch thick white cardstock, and I ran this leaf through like that. And then if you kind of leave it in there as much as you can, on this one, I actually stamped this and then put all this back together, and it was so hard to do. I'm not doing that again. So this time I just cut a bigger circle. So stamp your greeting, emboss it, or whatever you want to do. This one happens to come from the Frosted Gingerbread. I just kind of looked around for something that was that right size. I wanted something that was would fit in a circle. Stamped it, and then that will go behind here, just like that. And then that got layered on the gold, which I ended up using the gold, rose gold and the gold, the 6x6 paper that's in the annual catalog, which is so pretty. So that got layered on that, which got layered on the red card. This is what the rose gold looks like. That would be really pretty too, to have just sort of a pale pink theme. Now this one is gold with the same leaves, but on this one I did those pretty pine needles. And there's just enough room to come in here underneath it and tie a little gold cord on. And this little bird, my friend Stephanie sent me a whole bunch of birds because one day I said, I don't have any little bird dies. And she sent me a whole package of those. And those are from the Beauty of Friendship bundle in the annual catalog. So I just added those on. And to me, the best way to attach that is glue dots. This one I ran through after I cut this out. I ran that through the embossing folder. You can do it with or without this in there, but it kind of helps hold it all together. I ran it through the wood grain embossing folder. Let me see if I can get you an up close look there. It's pretty. And you don't have to use this whole sheet of gold if you don't want to. You could just cut a big square out of it and just use this little layer around the corner. So there is the sparkle of the season in three different holidays. Kind of fun. And I have to say, I don't send a ton of Halloween cards, but this one might be my favorite. Let me know what you think. We'll see you next time. See it, learn it, stamp it.